I'm just feeling slightly overwhelmed that I won it and that I now have some money to actually work with. I can do the projects that I've been sitting for about 2 years on my computer. Yeah, exciting.
Hollie McNish is one of those performers that you don't get a chance to wonder about what you like or enjoy about it because you're too busy enjoying the performance. I think, like Kate Tempest, to whom I think she's often rather unjustly compared because she's Kate's wonderful, but Hollie's a very different kind of performer in a way. They land a huge visceral punch, and you don't really have much chance to think, and you're swept along by the. It's not the drama of the thing because there's no acting. I think it's by the authenticity of the performance, I would say.
The day I'm laid to rest, and no, you're right, I said it's not the same. I did not turn into a car. I turn into a factory, a life support and cooker. As my body started morphing, my insides realigned, my digestive system shifted and completely redesigned itself. No help from the Autobots or the Decepticons.
I never performed my poetry until I was about 24. So I just wrote it and put it in boxes and read it to my mum and my partner. And that was it for a long time. And then I started reading it out. My partner sort of insisted that I try reading them out to other people because he thought they might help in some way more than they do if they just sit on my computer. And there are so many amazing spoken word artists, but there's no real spoken word in the mainstream still on television, on Radio 1, on Radio 1 Extra, and I think all that sort of just shows that it's still the underdog and it needs to, get some more attention, I think.